just before we start, I wanted to show you something that we mentioned, we talked about yesterday, when you asked me why do I think anger is overemphasized in China. And those are the six relationships I talked about yesterday. Three in the family, three in society. Father and son, husband and wife, elder brother, younger brother, prince and... Here it says prince and minister. I would say it's ruler and subject. Friend and friend. And crucially, teacher and student. Why crucially? Because I think that's been a weakness in the development of Chinese medicine in China. The excessive respect of the teacher. Some respect the teacher is nice. It can be excessive, i.e. the teacher can say all kinds of things and is never challenged. So that a mistake can be transmitted over generations and centuries because no one ever questions it, because the teacher said so. And you can see it. Sometimes you read the Chinese dictionary, and I was reading the explanation of the names of the points. I don't remember, it was a rank point here. And the name, the Chinese name means next to. And the explanation of the book was that point is called Ren 11, let's say it's Ren 11, it's called next to because it's next to Ren 10. But every point is next to another point. So the teacher says that, and no student would dare say, but excuse me, that doesn't make sense. Every point is next to another point. So I think that's been the excessive following of the teacher is actually has been a weakness of Chinese medicine. So if everything, the people here at the top have a duty of care for those at the bottom and responsibility, and those at the bottom have a crucially a duty of obedience and respect, and if everyone behaves according to these relationships, everything is fine in the family and society. And in fact, society reflects the harmony of the family. That's why when Confucius talked about the rectification of the names, have you heard that expression, the rectification of names by Confucius? And some people in Chinese medicine use that as a... as an excuse of saying that we should review all our terminology, blah, 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 blah. The rectification of names has nothing to do with the names. What he meant was that everyone has to act according to their name, i.e. their role. So anger, of all the emotions, is the one that is most disruptive. And that's what I was showing you yesterday. This character, ni, this word ni, occurs in Chinese medicine all the time. When a headache from liver yang rising is ni, which some authors translate as counterflow. I translate as rebellious. And look at the meaning of that word, rebellious. It's a very heavy political, social meaning. Rebellious, contrary, counter, disobey, defy, to go against. Paradoxically, that's Confucius, by the way. Chinese medicine in pathology, besides being a medical problem, is an ethical problem, if you know what I mean. It's ni, it's like something is going wrong in those relationships. Okay? And this is a word, this is the opposite of ni, and this is also a verb. We used it when you look at the symptom of liver yang rising. It says treatment principle, shun qi. Make qi go the right way. And look at the meaning of shun, to conform, to obey, to yield to act in submission to. So Chinese medicine is heavily influenced by Confucianism. and that's not recognized. We think it's all Taoist, and it's not.